Hello everyone. Previous lectures we already studied the simple parenchyma and simple collenchyma. That is, in simple permanent tissue we see, we already studied the parenchymatous tissue and collenchymatous tissue. Now the third type of simple permanent tissue is the sclerenchymatous tissue. Basically, the word sclerenchyma is derived from a Greek word that is sclerotos. The sclerotos means hard or tough. Sclerenchymatous tissues are basically hard, tough in nature, lignified in nature, so that's why the name has given from the word sclerotus, and hence we say that is the sclerenchyma or sclerenchymatous tissue. These sclerenchymatous tissues are highly thick. The cell walls are very thick. The walls are double, they are double wall. The cell walls are lignified, the cells are lignified, elongated, compactly arranged. Generally we say in case of parenchyma, the cells are loosely arranged. But here the sclerenchyma are, the cells of the sclerenchyma are very compactly arranged. It is in which the intercellular spaces are absent because of, due to the compact arrangement, the intercellular spaces are absent. The cell wall is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose or pectin. Due to the deposition of pectin as well as lignin, the cell lumen get narrow. The cavity in the sclerenchymatous cells becomes very narrow, and sometimes the protoplast of the cell wall, or particularly the cell, the protoplast of the cell becomes to be lost. Hence, the sclerenchyma is to be the dead tissue. We say that dead tissue because of, due to the protoplast is to be lost. So, because of such a hard and lignified nature of the sclerenchyma, the sclerenchymatous cells are provide the mechanical support to the plant. It provide the mechanical strength to the plant. Hence, it is called as the mechanical tissues. Basically, we see here the structure of sclerenchymatous cells, the double wall, highly thick. Cell wall is very thick, double wall, lignified, and on the cell wall there is a deposition of thickening. The thickening which is to be deposited on the wall of the sclerenchyma by different types of pectin or as well as the lignin. So due to that, there is a thickening is created, or thin areas are remains on them. So that's why that thickening is because of, due to the deposition. So the cells are elongated, or it is elongated as like the fibers. So such type of the sclerenchyma is elongated one. If we see the cross sectional view, and this one is the lateral view or whole fiber of sclerenchyma. If we see the sclerenchyma, when they are arranged in the tissues, particularly they are interlocking with each other, and ultimately it gives a mechanical strength to the plant due to such kind of the sclerenchymatous fibers are to be arranged. So the sclerenchyma is again of two types, or classified into two types. One is fiber and other is scleroids. Fibers and scleroids. So this is the fibers. This is the fibers, and this one is the sclerites. The fibers are elongated one. The fibers are to be elongated one. It is present. It is very lignified due to deposition of the thickening of the fibers. The cell lumen get narrow. The passage becomes to be very narrow. The cavity of the fibers are very narrow one, and it is interlocking with each other. The fibers are present inside the xylem tissue as well as in the phloem tissue. So that's why it is called as a xylem fibers or phloem fibers. That's why it is also called as xylem fibers as well as phloem fibers. So basically, this is the sclerenchymatous tissue. It is associated with the xylem as well as with the phloem. So that's why they are called as xylem and phloem fibers. Second one is the sclerites. Sclerites are isobidiametric. They may be oval, they may be a round. So such type of, that means oval, it may be rounded one, highly tough, and there is a thickening of the depositions are having on the sclerites. These sclerites are present on the different seed coat and as well as on the fruits, wall of the fruits, out of pericarp of the fruit. So this due to the sclerites, the seed coat and the pericarp of the fruits become to be tough and hard one. So that's why these sclerites are the such kind of the blunt tissues. While in case of the fibers, the end wall is tapering, narrower, so pointed one. Here the end wall is blunt one. It becomes to be blunt. It becomes to be ovate, or sometimes it becomes circular or rounded. So this is the main difference in the fibers and sclerites one. The fibers are highly lignified one. It has provided the mechanical strength, and due to the sclerites, the seed wall and the seed coat is become to be tough and hard one. Okay. See you.